All right, here we are. Report number two. Now, since I've done all this work this morning here on this Good Friday the 13th, tomorrow Valentine's Day, where you can fabricate your hearts, and I just got done posting all the checks that I wrote, trust checks that I wrote on my Facebook account. I've specially customized my Facebook account. It has all my information and my public record. Not all of it, but enough. I'm still keeping some aces in the pocket now. Remember, a good man keeps his aces in the pocket. He always keeps some aces in the pocket, man. But after I got done tediously photocopying everything for the bank's websites, front and the back of the checks, the three checks that I was most concerned about, because the first check that went through went negative in the account. That was for the power company for $528. The next check, next three checks, finally all of a sudden came through as I finished my posting on Facebook. After I went back to the post office, because I needed to, somehow I lost a copy of my paperwork. So I had to go back to the post office, tell them to give me back the registered envelope, take my stuff out and go back to the copy machine, the copy place at FedEx, make some more copies, and add the banker's card onto the copy too. But she already signed it. I got the banker to sign and timestamp everything. My trust check that I gave her. And because I want her to put my trust check in to cover the overdrafts. I says, this is a counter check. That means it's a counterclaim check. If you understand law, private maritime law, what a counterclaim is. So, do your studies, Solutions of Commerce, type it in the YouTube search, listen to Winston teach it. But, so, I redid my certified letter. Well, I just made new copies. I didn't have to redo the certified. Put it all back together, gave it back to her. I came home and I listened to some more White House. They're doing cybersecurity, man. And I'm just getting all kinds of signs and excellent understanding of how this nation's actually working, man. I understand the justice system much more clear, man. The good guys in the federal government, man, they are for us putting these liens in. you start to see it in all the verbiage, man. All right, and to utilize, enforce the liens, because that's what I've just done now. I have enforced my lien with a gun now, because I sent this to criminal investigation. That's the military. That's the military. They hold a gun now, all this information. So in case something goes wrong, they know what to do. So I'm the boss, and I told them what to do. I gave them orders what to do. I just gave the military orders. Now, and you understand this when you get the big picture of who you are. A secured lien claimant, secured prior creditor, however you want to call yourself, man. All kinds of different ways you can call yourself. It's all the same thing. Different names, same thing. So, when I got home and I was listening to cybersecurity at the White House, listening to them live, because on YouTube live, and then I went and checked my bank account then, and I said, oh man, the other three checks came through. So that's when I decided to photocopy all those and put them on my Facebook like I did that first check that I gave the banker. It was a $1,000 check. I said, I want this counterclaim check deposited into the bank. And I was nice to her, and I told her I'm here in peace and all that. I wasn't ordering her around or nothing, and we were talking friendly. And she was, you know, kind of like, whoa, 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 you know, at times, you know, like, but you know, I presented myself professionally, you know, peacefully, and we left on good terms and everything. You know, that's the only way to do it is peace. And you want to be up front. I'm here at peace. I'm not here to cause any harm. I'm here for the safety. We don't want any riots going on. No public hazards. Now let her know. So anyway, I looked on the bank account and three more checks came through. It was for $125 for my military plates, which tells me that if that check just went through, then they got paid. Something tells me they got paid. So that makes me feel a little bit better. So that means all I gotta do is wait 45 days. Supposedly. Now it just makes me feel a little bit better. But I'm gonna go talk, and then the one other check was for $283. So I'm gonna go talk to him probably Monday. Go talk to the insurance agents right down here on the corner, and see if it actually cleared in his bank. And then there was another check for $183,000. So that's one, two. Oh, and I uploaded the $528 one that I sent to the power company. So I could actually call the power company right now and see if that check made it through. That will let me know if negative balance checks actually get paid. They close at 5, so shoot, why don't I just give them a call right now? Okay. Keyboard's out, so I gotta use this. It's missing some letters. So all right, here we go.
We could not complete your call.
Phone's ringing. I need to see if a check cleared.
Okay. Open project share.
Okay, now I'm going to stop the video because I don't want to put my personal information on this video, so I'll start again after the phone call.